In this lecture, we will be seeing about the reception of digital TV signals in case of DVB-S, DVB-C and DVB-T. So this is a complete transmission reception chain of the digital video broadcasting. So what are the steps? First of all, source coding has to be done, then followed by channel coding, modulation, then up conversion, amplification, then towards any of the medium, that is either via cable, satellite or a terrestrial medium. It is being sent, and at the receiver, the complementary steps, whatever being performed at the transmitter, its reverse operations has to be done. So in the further section, we will be seeing about the reception in the case of cable, satellite and terrestrial. Now here we know that there will be n number of programs which can be multiplexed and MPEG coded, and these are the packetry elementary streams, and it can be multiplexed and scrambled, and the standard for MPEG 2 it is a 188 byte packet. So 188 byte packets, they are being again so they are all being scrambled, multiplexed, etc., and finally forms this 188. And then there will be the channel corrections, the Reed Solomon coding, etc. Further all these channel estimations will be done. Then it will be further subjected to modulation, that is the I and Q signals, that is the in-phase and quadrature phase signals. They will be modulating in QPSK, that is in case of satellite, then in QAM, quadrature amplitude modulation, that is higher order QAM in case of cable, and it will be using COFDM in case of the terrestrial conditions. Then finally, it will be up converted into appropriate frequency band. Depending upon the medium, the frequency will be taken, amplified, and for the transmission of the end users. So this is a complete DVB transmission or reception chain. So let us see first of all the block diagram of a DVB satellite receiver. So these are its components. So whatever operations have been performed at the transmitter side, its reverse has to be performed. So when you are looking at the block diagram, at the end position here you can see that source decoding is done. Okay, so this is we should be having MPEG 2 decoder, which is going to give us the audio and video decoded signals. And then further we should be having this channel decoding, since we have performed channel coding at the transmitting side. Then we should be having demodulation. This block diagram indicates a demodulation, together with it has to perform some functions like carrier recovery and provide automatic gain control, etc. And so first and foremost, it will be having a tuner circuit, that is for receiving the signals. For example, if it is receiving through satellite, it has to down convert, receive, amplify it to a level, or down convert to a level. Then we should be converting it to digital by using analog to digital conversion. That is, at the transmitting side, we will be having DAC, digital to analog converter, for modulating. So here the reverse, okay, we should be having ADC followed by demodulation, then channel decoding, then we should be having the source coding. So prior to source decoding, we should be having all these, that is descrambling, demultiplexing, etc. Why? Because we have actually scrambled and multiplexed our source at the transmitter. So we have to demultiplex, descramble all this, then only we will be getting which program we require. Okay, so these are the basic steps. Same steps will be there in the case of DVB cable receiver. The only difference, it will be in the case of tuning, that is what frequency, depending upon the medium, the frequency of the tuning will be different, and also the modulation. The important, most important difference is the regarding the modulation. If you are having QPSK for satellite, we will be having higher order QAM in case of cable. That is the only difference in this case you can observe. All the other parts, that is all these, are going to remain one and the same. But this is not the case with the terrestrial receiver. The terrestrial receiver, the front end of the DVB-T, it will be having little more steps, since we have done COFDM modulation at the transmitting side. So it will be different, only the front end. The rest all part, that is regarding these part, that is descrambling, demultiplexing and source decoding, it will be same for DVB-T also. So first, let us see about the DVB satellite receiver. So the first and foremost, in the case of a satellite antenna, we will be having a low noise converter. That is, the radio waves which is being received from this satellite dish, it will be converted to a low noise signal. That is, we will be having here a combination of low noise amplifier, frequency mixer, local oscillator, etc. It will be actually what? Down converted to the IF. And we have to understand that we use a special filter, that is surface acoustic wave filter in case of tuner. That is a low cost RF filter which we always employ for wide applications. In the case of digital video broadcasting, always we use a SAW filter, that is a surface acoustic wave filter, which converts this electrical energy to acoustic waves and then backwards. Okay, so in the case of satellite, it will select the required RF channel, and in the case of satellite, it will be in the range of 950 to 2150 megahertz, and the IF which it converts, it will be in the range of 480 megahertz. Okay, so this will be the frequency range in the case of satellite. Here 950 to 2150 megahertz will be received, and the IF range, it will be 480 megahertz. Okay, then it will be further amplified and again demodulated in order to obtain the I and Q signals. And then we are having the recovery of the carrier phase, etc. They will be done in combination of the next stages. That is, we are having a carrier recovery loop. That is, for locking the frequency, sampling frequency and symbol frequency. So this ADC is the one which is going to receive this signals. That is, analog signals it is receiving after being amplified and down converted into the required IF range by the tuner. We get the analog signals, I and Q signals. By using a ADC, we are converting it into digital. We have used here a 6-bit resolution. Okay, it is using a 6-bit resolution in case of a satellite receiver. And then the sampling frequency here is also locked to the symbol frequency by means of a phase lock loop. And this further, it is being given to a QPSK, which is going to demodulate it. And in addition to all this demodulation, it performs the half Nyquist filtering and carrier recoveries, etc. So we know that for preventing the inter-symbol interference, we always perform this Nyquist filtering. So in order to optimize the bandwidth and signal to noise ratio requirement, whatever operation is being performed at the transmitter, that same will be performed at the receiver. So half Nyquist filtering will be performed at the transmitter side, and again half Nyquist filtering will be performed at the receiver side. So this block, it is for demodulation, QPSK demodulator. In addition to that, it performs also the filtering, carrier recovery loops, etc. Then further, we will be having about the forward error correction. That is, it does a complete error correction. That is, in the order, reverse order. That is, it starts with Viterbi decoding, de-interleaving, and finally the Reed-Solomon decoding. That is a reverse of what we have performed in the transmitter side. Then it goes to the descrambler. What is the function of descrambler? That is, it is receiving these transport packets, which is always in the size of 188 byte. Then it is going to descramble. That is, it will be communicating with the main processor. As you can see, there will be a powerful RISC processor, and it will be communicating with the main processor by parallel bus, and it will be descrambling the packet. So since we have done scrambling and multiplexing, we have to do the reverse. Then again demultiplexing with the help of programmable filters, etc. With the we have to demultiplex it. Then only we have to give it to MPEG decoder. So in the MPEG decoder, the audio and the video output from the demultiplexer, it is applied to the input. As you can see, packetized elementary stream is applied here. It is going to give the audio and the video signals, analog signals. So this DENC, that is a digital video encoder, what does it do? It converts the whatever signals it is receiving, it will be converted into the analog RNGB. That is what is written. It will be converting into analog signals for the best quality of display on a TV set. And here we will be having the decompressed digital audio signals. When they are fed to a DAC, that is also going to give the analog audio signal. So this is the complete block diagram for the DVB satellite receiver. So in addition, you can see that we are having the processor, that is a microprocessor. It is controlled by 32-bit RISC processor, and there will be communication ports to communicate with the external world, like a modem, etc. And there will be also smart card reader. So smart card reader, it is mainly used to provide authority to the users. Okay, it will be a card inserted with a chip, and it will be containing the user ID authorization number also. So based upon that only, we can have the authorization to watch the TV programs. For that, why we have used a smart card reader. And one more another thing to remember is that we call the IRD, we call this system at the front end, we call it as an integrated receiver decoder. Okay, so when we are speaking of the circuit, that is about the reception, we should also know about the important term that is called as integrated receiver decoder. That is, what does it do is that it receives a signal and it converts the modulated signal back into a format which is suitable for presentation to an end user device or display. So we basically do the decoding process here. Okay. So it is an integrated receiver decoder. So this is a block diagram of a DVB cable receiver. So this is going to differ only in terms of mainly QAM modulation and also regarding the frequency band. Cable frequency band, it will be in the UHF or VHF range. So you can see the frequency difference which is coming here in case of satellite and also in the case of cable. So when we are seeing in the case of cable, first of all, the tuner, it will be selecting the desired frequency range and down converting to IF. Now here the range of frequency, it is going to be different. That is, it will be converting to a frequency of only say IF of 36.15 megahertz. Okay, so in the earlier case, it is different. So here the IF range is 36.15 megahertz. Then the ADC is there. That is with the resolution of 8 or 9 bits. And here the sampling frequency, you can see it is 4 times a simple frequency. So different resolution, and the sampling frequency is 4 times a simple frequency in this case. And you can see there is a demodulation, QAM demodulation, and also performs a half Nyquist filtering, etc. And there is a carrier recovery loop. And another thing to remember is that this is a case of cable, so it will be subjected to echoes. So at this stage, some echo equalization also need to be performed, which is not required in the case of satellite receiver. Okay, so here it is demodulated, half Nyquist filtering is done, carrier recovery loop is being done, and some echo equalization may also be required since it is a cable medium. And then we will be having the channel correction, that is a channel decoding, de-interleaving, Reed Solomon decoding, all these. And the rest of the steps, it is going to be same as that of the satellite decoder. Okay, so all these other steps are going to be same. And remember that it is having the communication to the external ports like the modem, etc. And all this is controlled by a powerful RISC processor. And these decoding, etc., requires large amount of memory. That is why it's shown the memory here, DRAM of 16 megabits. And these are the standard conversions. And finally, we get the signals, analog audio signals and the video signals, which is suitable for viewing by the end users. Okay, so all together, if we are comparing these two blocks, satellite and cable, main difference is in the case of modulation. That is, for satellite, we employ QPSK. And for cable, we employ QAM. That is the main difference. Then regarding the resolutions of ADC, which we are using. And another important difference is in the range of frequency. That is the IF range chosen in the case of satellite and in the case of cable, it is going to be different. And also, we have to understand that echo equalizations may be necessary in case of cable. Okay, rest all are going to be same. Now, when we come to the block diagram of a digital terrestrial TV receiver, the front end of the DVB-T, it is going to be slightly different. Okay, because since it is performing the COFDM modulation at the transmitting side, it is going to be different. So first of all, we'll be having a tuner. It will select the desired channel that is also in the VHF-UHF band. So the band is same as that of the cable. So it will be converting it into intermediate frequency of 36.15 megahertz. So that IF range is same for that of the cable and terrestrial. Then it will be given to the ADC. And in the case of ADC, it is digitized with the sampling frequency. That is FS is given here. So the standard value of sampling frequency here is 20 megahertz. Okay, so the FS value is 20 megahertz in this case, and then we perform the COFDM demodulation. That is, the I and Q signals, they will be reconstituted from the digitized IF signals, and the OFDM signals, they are being demodulated. So we know that we will be having either a 2K or a 8K COFDM demodulation, and the specification will be given. For example, here it is 2K. Written here, the specification will be mentioned either for 2K or the 8K. So at this step, we are going to do the demodulation. So whatever modulation, COFDM modulation we have done at the transmitting, we are doing the demodulation in this case. And then we are having the channel correction. So this performs the estimation of the transmission channel and the correction. And then by using the information which we get from the channel correction, we are going to provide the time and frequency correction of the demodulation. So these two steps are connected. So when we are actually demodulating the OFDM signals by means of FFT, that is, in the case of transmitting sound, we have finally done a inverse fast Fourier transform. So first of all, in the receiver side for demodulation, first step which we are performing is FFT. Then once it is sent to channel correction, from the information we are getting in the channel correction, we are doing the time and frame synchronization, okay, by using the information we receive from the channel correction. Then final step is channel decoding, that is, it performs it in the reverse order, okay. So in the transmitting side, initially we perform the randomizing, read Solomon coding. So here it is in the reverse order we have to perform these steps, and then it will be given as a transport stream. Now the rest of the steps are similar. That is, this much part it is going to be after the channel correction, whatever is coming, that is descrambling, demultiplexing, this part is going to remain same for DVB-T also. Only the front end of the DVB-T, it is going to be different. Okay, so these are the block diagrams of the transmission of the DVB-C, DVB-S and DVB-T, with the main only some differences in the case of cable and satellite. And the front end is going to differ for DVB-T since we are doing COFDM modulation at the transmitting end.